Mobile you shape showing you how to measure 32.768 kilohertz crystal using my oscilloscope Unity UTD2102CX100 MHz oscilloscope. Okay, so first I will place my probe on this point, on this connection of the crystal. Now let's see on this oscilloscope. See, here you can see only one straight line. See, you can see here only there is one straight line here. Okay, no waveform. Now let's configure it properly so that we can see a proper waveform on the screen and check whether that crystal is working or not. First, since it is measuring DC and waveform is AC, I will change it to AC coupling. Okay, see, we are getting a slight variations in the reading now. I will now adjust this DSO, that is oscilloscope, so that we can clearly see a waveform. First, I will adjust the scale. Okay, see, I am lowering here voltage levels. I am zooming in. Now, I will zoom in the time level. Now again I will zoom in the voltage levels. Now it is 100 millivolts, so every division is 100 millivolts. I want to see bigger waveform, so I will zoom it more to 50 millivolts. So every division is 50 millivolts voltage here, this division vertical. Now I will adjust time. It is 20 microseconds. I will adjust it to 10 microseconds now, see. And since it is generating very fast, I will set the trigger level so that it will be in steady waveform. See, it is up now. I will bring it low. I will manually trigger it so that it becomes stable. Yeah, see, this is the perfect procedure to measure waveforms. Now I'll click the measure button. Measure. See guys, you can see here the frequency is 32.77 or 78, whatever it is. So it is 32.768 actual, so there will be slight variation. So now it is, clock crystal is working perfectly. See here, if you want to see continuous, then you just have to raise the trigger bar above. Manually trigger. If you don't know how to do settings of DSO, you just need to press auto button. Whereas the DSO will automatically configure itself, just in case you don't know how to do it. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.